Welcome back to another Real Talk Reaction. This one is for Arrested Development Season 2, Episode Number 10. Hey, don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell as well. It helps the algorithm when you tell a friend to tell a friend. Thank you.
Shout out to executive producer JoJo for the comment on Episode 9 saying J-Rabbit unintentionally forgetting Anne's name. Priceless. Also, great cameos from some before they were famous actors. Dave K., the same year Anchorman came out, and Brian B., Kevin, and Jack McBrayer, Kenneth, before The Office, and 30 Rock. Alright, let's jump into episode 10 right now.
Bluth arrived home to find his mother, Lucille, in a state of agitation.
I think the company's in trouble.
What tipped you? With falling profits, or that were a regular feature on Bill O'Reilly's most ridiculous item of the day?
I'm talking about the fact that my friend, Lucille Ostero, bought our company, and I think she's going for a power grab. That bitch!
You're not at home, Mom. She doesn't live next door
right
here.
Right.
She's the majority shareholder of the company.
I'll tell you what she wants to grab. Your brother, Job.
In fact, Lucille, too, was already with Job.
You look really nice.
But she was growing tired of his neediness.
I'm going to my spin class.
Wow.
But you had vertigo.
She'll sell the company or break it.
She got cured. She really listened.
About our family.
Gotta stop quoting when you drink.
Right.
I certainly hope she's not planning a move.
I wouldn't put it past her. She'd love to get at me any way she could. That's why she's been flirting with Job. She's trying to prove that she's closer to my children than I am, but the joke's on her because she doesn't know how little I care for Job.
I care for Job.
Yeah.
Hey,
buddy.
Is that
Gangi?
Was just...
Sure.
Oh,
yeah, I got you wasted.
Oh, what accident here?
Oh, does that mean she's going to have to come live with us?
No.
Not that kind of accident.
It was your drink, and even if it wasn't... Do you remember when I bid on Sally Sitwell at the Bachelorette auction? They sent me this basket with all this stuff for our date, you know, it's a whole package. Anyway, I thought maybe we could do it together, you know, sort of like a Valentine's present.
You're not going to take Sally?
Sally, no. No, I wanted it for us. I never wanted to be with Sally.
Actually, Michael had gone over to Sitwell Enterprises.
Michael blew to see Sally.
One day earlier to set up a date with Sally.
I'm afraid she's not here, Michael. If you'd like me to take the package, I can give it to her.
No, this is not for her. It's for my son. Just don't tell her I came by.
In fact, Sally wasn't there. And the person Michael saw was her father.
This makes me look like my daughter.
Well, no one's going to think that.
I look like you.
Like an error.
Yeah, I'm going to get to spin class.
So what do you say? We got a basketball father-son fun here.
What's kind of situation?
Did you guys see Lucille too?
Mm-hmm. Maybe it's not for us.
Valentine's Day. When she...
Everybody would get busted as shit.
Well, that is quite a basket you've got there, Michael. That Sally Sitwell is one lucky lady.
Yeah, well, I'm not so sure that she's actually right for me anyway, but you got one of these too, didn't you? You bought Lindsay at the same auction.
Well, yes, but I'm afraid I prematurely shot my wad on what was supposed to be a dry run, if you will, so now I'm afraid I have something of a mess on my hands.
Just there's so many poorly chosen words.
Yeah,
this
I don't know what you're trying to say.
Sure,
at all.
Everything was perfect for Lindsay, so
I'm pretty sure
to
shot my wad.
Body talking.
Body talking.
Oh my god, babe, he went and did everything.
It's a wonderful package. I'll take it. He just did.
Why don't you take this?
He used it all for himself, baby.
Can you imagine how jealous that would make
he
her?
He just did.
Where's Tobias? Oh, he's just sharing a romantic horseback ride with Michael Bluth, and they're dipping each other in... Oh, you didn't get any body chocolate.
Body chocolate.
I didn't mean with me. I hate to see you struggle like this. In fact...
I hate to see you struggle.
Why don't you let me ask her for you?
Oh, Michael, you really are quite the Cupid, aren't you? I tell you, you can zing your arrow into my buttocks anytime.
Oh my god.
You know what you're doing? You buy yourself a tape recorder, you just record yourself for a whole day. I think you're going to be surprised.
Lucille.
Ah! Oh, Jesus!
You're fabulous! Back to the blonde!
Oof.
Is she beautiful?
Oh, yeah.
Kind of scary, that guy, huh?
No, not to me. I think he's kind of cool.
Well, why don't you go get your kiss from Mr. Cool Half Man?
I'd be fine with that, so what's your point?
Okay, I'll be fine with that.
This is no bigger than one of my legs. Shake them for her.
Do it!
Oh, ragdoll.
Oh my god!
Just ignore it! Just something the body does when you shake it. Don't shake it!
What? Why is that great hair, man?
I wonder if he's dying.
Boy, that giraffe is cute, huh?
What, the deaf giant who's holding our fake uncle?
He's been flirting with me all night.
Oh my god.
Oh my god,
he's
the worst.
I'd ask her to family if I went on that romance thing with drag instead of Dubois, which would be a drag.
Yeah, that's just the kind of joke drag can't hear. No, you're gonna go with Tobias or not at all. Now tell me what you found out at Sitwell.
Yeah, you still want me to do that?
You didn't? Lindsay, I give you one thing to do for the business.
You still want me to do that?
I understand, but you didn't even try it.
So I didn't even fail, and I don't see you giving me credit for that.
Michael knew that since Lindsay let him down, he had no choice but to ask Uncle Jack for the money to save his company.
Pretty.
You think you should be perched on the edge of the building like this?
Oh, dragon's got me.
Dragon's in the bathroom.
Mama!
Mama! Gotcha. It's okay.
Dragon's
and
getting
so
me.
So Michael laid out his dilemma.
To see the family company get ruined.
I was hoping that this was a social...
His makeup looks insane.
He pulled me super old.
To get out of you when that sister of yours started giving me the cutie eye.
Today?
Unfortunately, that moose was holding me, so I couldn't make my move. Of course, I couldn't make that move without that moose, but that's my challenge. I want the wheelchair! Twirl me around. No! But Valentine's Day is here, and I'm alone. The moose is no one. Perhaps if I had a little companionship, I'd be a little more disposed to whip out that old wall out of mine.
Saying if I were to set you up with my sister, you would consider bailing us out?
Oh, yeah.
Michael was torn. The business meant the world to him. But his sister's honor...
Let's do it.
Meant a lot, too.
Let's go show you the
he got his arms. He can get out.
I know. Why is he acting like his arms are
Michael somewhere? Had offered his sister to his Uncle Jack in exchange for money to save the company. Remember, it's not their real uncle.
That's the biggest thing.
Yeah. Imagine him without that muscly little old guy in his arms.
Oh, Dragon. Right. Well, that's why I was thinking maybe you should go with Dragon on that romantic getaway.
Huh? Oh.
I mean, I know he's working, so Uncle Jack's going to have to go along.
Oh, as long as he promises not to shake him.
Mm.
So what did he say about the money?
He said he'd like to sleep on it.
Meanwhile, Buster had decided to pursue
right.
a new girlfriend. His old girlfriend.
Hey, brother. What are you doing here?
I'm keeping an eye on the woman who controls our company.
In her robe and slippies?
Into her head.
The robe and slippies?
She's planning on selling our company to Stan Sitwell. I've lost her trail. I don't think I have the skills to pick it up.
Skills.
4 minutes later.
Yes, skills.
Anyway,
but if you give me one of those outfits, we can hide in the bushes or something and spy on them.
I would like to see her again.
You've got it.
And Michael told
hey,
his
what happened in these 4 minutes? He like broke
Jack.
The window,
yeah,
cut
right
up his face.
Well, you were pimping out my mother.
Yes, because she was sleeping with my brother, but your sister.
It's your sister.
No one's going to get hurt. No one is going to get hurt.
Oh, hey, Michael. My dad wanted me to thank you for the romantic getaway. Don't tell me what that means.
Where is your dad?
He loves Uncle Jack.
My pleasure. It's nice to do something you don't need legs for. Whoa!
Oh my god, ew!
And Lucille too.
Just something happens to the body when you shake.
Who did look a little like Edgar Winter. And one by one, they each enjoyed the activities of their romantic getaways.
Is body chocolate?
No.
Of course, in the spa, the jets proved too powerful for Uncle Jack's tiny legs. The spa portion also proved challenging to Stan Sitwell and Lucille too. Who in turn were being followed by Buster.
Oh my god, babe. Buster's going hard right now.
And Joe.
Laying motherfuckers out.
And soon, Michael and Tobias awaited their massage therapist.
So, Tobias, I'm afraid that your wife might not actually end up here with you.
You know, Michael, perhaps I should buy you that tape recorder. Do you have any idea how often you say the word afraid?
Well, I know I used it in the jacuzzi.
And I apologize for that. I thought it was a pool toy. But you were supposed to be here with Sally Sitwell, but you were afraid to ask her. So what do? You create issues, and you make up imaginary problems like this merger I hear you're worried about.
This merger I hear you're worried about.
You're probably right about me being afraid of the word no, but...
It's not an imaginary problem.
He's just out here knocking people the fuck out.
Michael.
What are you doing here?
Calling Lucille, too. She's with Stickman. She probably figured that we'd never track her. But we lost her. Everyone put on white robes and outsmarted us. You see ya.
Everybody put on white robes and outsmarted us.
Lindsay.
Wait. Lindsay's here?
Lindsay.
With two men?
Sort of one and a half.
Two and a half.
Hey, Tobias.
Lindsay. Look, Lucille, too. I'm sorry.
Tobias.
I don't know your name.
Lucille, Sitwell, what's this?
It's our romantic getaway, Michael.
Romantic? So then the company isn't being taken over, so Lindsay doesn't have to be with Uncle Jack? Oh, Tobias, we're gonna stop Lindsay. Tobias? Tobias?
Would you like to take a nap, Baldy? I'll handle this. She's my girlfriend, pal.
Take him down, Buster.
Your girlfriend?
That's why you were in a robe and slippies. You
and slippies.
Into her head. You were trying to get into her robe and slippies. She's my girlfriend! No!
So this is who you choose over me?
Oh, she's not with him! She's with the bullet!
Oh, thank God.
But if you want to fight, you got it. Shoot me!
Look, I wasn't trying to sell your company, but I am now!
The hell with all of you? I'm gonna
try and lowball
her.
Oh
try lowball her.
What have I done here, Joe?
Tobias, I'm sorry. I set this up for Lindsay. Lindsay, I'm sorry. You were not on a date with Dragon.
Just like Tobias said, you're creating problems.
Obviously, man. Dragon kept swooping Uncle Jack in for a kiss. He said I never did anything for the company. I just thought I'd try. Tobias, I never thought you'd ever fight for me.
No idea a 90-year-old man could cave in my chest cavity like that.
Dragon, would you mind carrying my husband?
Oh my God.
Oh! I love taking a guy down. I think I snapped one of his ribs. No, it's my leg. That would hurt.
I guess the deal's off now? Now that I actually need you to help us out?
I'll make you a deal. You carry me, and I'll carry you.
Thanks, Uncle Jack.
Yeah.
Maybe
we should get him to the hospital. Duct tape is the only thing that's keeping the ankle on.
Duct tape is the only thing keeping the ankle on.
We're right inside me now.
On the next story,
right inside me now.
Uncle Jack buys the company, but makes some changes of his own.
And he's going to make me president.
Oh my God, baby.
Tobias listens to a day's worth of his own words to see what Michael was referring to.
Oh, now she got me pregnant.
Even if it means me taking a chubby, I will suck it up.
Nothing wrong with that.
This for a while, but I just can't seem to get one in the can.
Out of context.
I wouldn't mind kissing that man between the cheeks, so to speak.
And he realizes there is something distinct about the way he speaks.
Tobias, you blow hard.
Oh my God.
All right, that was Arrested Development 2:10, and man, I thought it was an okay episode. A little weird, a little bit gross with Martin Short coming through. I wish that would have been a little funnier. I think it would have been if he wasn't. I mean, I know they was going for the funny with the big guy carrying him around, but it just didn't land for me on that one. It probably would have been better if he came in like a wheelchair or the crutches maybe, and then did all that, you know, by itself. But having the other person hold him around, he just didn't really get a chance to do a whole lot with that part that he did. Tobias, again, coming through with some of the best lines for me anyway for this episode during the show and then after the show as well. Then everything else just kind of, you know, just worked itself out on for that part. So I thought this episode was okay, but I really did like the post-credit scene. Can't wait to see another one, though.
Yeah, it was cool seeing Martin Short in the context of this show. I think some of it worked. I mean, I'm never a fan of the stuff that's gross and, like, spitting and all that. Like, I'm just not going to watch it. But I think all the other elements played well. I think if they would have stayed in that, like, smaller niche and not expanded it as much as they did, it would have been overall more funny. But it was great. Cameo, I loved seeing him. He's fantastic, so that was really cool. But I agree. I think, to me, Tobias is just, like, consistently hilarious. And even the fact that he took Michael's, took Michael's advice, recorded his entire day, and sees nothing wrong with it is fucking fantastic. I love it so much. So, yeah, that was definitely the highlight for me. This episode was Tobias.
Yeah. All right, well, look, thank you guys again for watching another Real Talk Reaction 4, Arrested Development Season 2, Episode 10. Until next time, people, peace.